Greetings, metal community. It's Roger back with another video. Part two of the 7-inch singles of mine. In the background, we are listening to The End by Ereb Altur. You know, epic Viking metal. Yeah, let's just jump right into it. I will try to keep it shorter this time than last time, but set lists, or how the hell you pronounce this name. Sorry. Crematory cover on the B-side. And just a kind of liner note lyric sheet. Of course, the Crypt of Kerberos that I showed the other day in the Crypt of Kerberos video. For those who have not seen that, we can just show you how it looks. This ugly orange splatter, or should we call it black pool splatter, maybe, in honor of Mark G. Cult of Fire, cannot pronounce any title or anything. Czechia's, you know, one of the best black metal bands. Kaothian, Denmark, if I don't remember wrong. There's nothing much to see here. Out on extremely rotten production. Then we have Korniger. Shroud of Satan, Death Triumphor, Tremorph, Territorial Possessions. Great black metal. You know, cold, old school, primitive, Cerecloth, Halo of Syringes, out on Hell's Headbangers. This is a great one. And we have Darkened. Pretty well-known band the last 5 years or so. No, it's just pure black, yeah. No lyric sheet or anything, it's just about a cool artwork. As always, with Darkened. Mr. Castellano, I presume. Juanjo Castellano, yeah. He does a lot of great covers. Then over to a very well-known band. It's Destroyer 666. Yeah, nothing. Not an insert on this one either, but that's okay. Great EP or single, I don't know what people say it. I call it singles, but you know. We have a split with Decrepitap and yeah, get it out. Eroded. See that? Fold out. Pretty good stuff. Decrepitap is one killer old school sounding death metal band. They have not released a lot of stuff, but they are pretty good. And we have an old, I don't know if it's a bootleg or official release, I don't remember. Aggressive Thunder Side A is a unreleased studio track and also a cover of Kiss, God of Thunder. That was kind of the reason why I bought this one. I like that cover, actually. One cover that I do like. Maybe I should do a video of covers I like. Cover songs that I like. Yeah, what a cool cool piece. I don't know, as I said, if it's this Made in Hell. Probably a bootleg. Then another one of those CDs that looks like a single. This is a full-length album, actually. Check it out. Okay. Kind of looks like this. So yeah, pretty unique. The band is Deception. I think they're from Poland. Yeah, pretty sure they're from Poland. Kind of, and a good death metal release. I haven't listened to it for a long time, but I remember it to be good, but nothing spectacular about it. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Styroman? I do believe. You can try and read that logo. I think it's Styroman. Yeah, it says Styroman here, so three songs. Can't say I remember anything about this one. I haven't spun this in years. And we have a pretty cool picture disc. And the legendary Dismember. Skin Her Alive. Yeah, this is a pretty damn cool. I mean, I love the artwork on this. Absolute killer. There's no sleeve or anything, you know, as normal with picture discs. I think I did pay some extra euros for that one. Then we have Decoherence. I mean, sometimes you have to wonder. It's kind of yeah. Another piece. This was a colored kind of semi-transparent red. You know, it fits the cover, but it's not black. Sleeve as well, without destroying anything. I haven't listened to this either for a long, long time, so maybe I need to take a day with just playing 7 inches. But it's called, on the hype stick, it says soul ravaging and mind-altering black metal from the UK. I don't know about that, but yeah. Detente. My copy is 46 out of 100. It's always cool when handwritten, you know, limitations on the. So yeah, Detente is pretty well known. This is, of course, without Don Crosby being a newer release. Then again, another CD. Really cool skull there as well. This have a really cool booklet as well. With a lot of great artwork. So yeah, what's this is Death Karma, the history of death and burial rituals part 2, so it's kind of a compilation in some sorts. But again, they fit very well in with the CDs. And it's a cool, I think it's cool with the CD releases, but you know, they don't fit in the rest of the CDs, so it's kind of annoying in that perspective, but yeah. Just another cool one that we have, an old Exodus Live, again probably a bootleg of some sorts, live at Mabuhay Gardens, San Francisco, 1983. Nothing, you know, no labels or anything, and you have to have that centerpiece to play it. Yeah, again, I haven't listened to this for a long time, but again, it's a bootleg, but I don't mind bootlegs when it's kind of live recordings that never have been released or anything. That's totally fine with me. So another CD, Enslaved, with Axioma Etika Odini. But this has actually got a single with it, so I can get it out. Jotun Blue Doom version. So that's a pretty cool cool release as well. It has this lyric sheet. So yeah, it's cool to have the extra bonus tracks on a single. That's pretty rare. So I don't know how many issues they did of this, but it's cool. It's a cool piece. I like it. Then we have Eternal Solstice with Brutal Awakening on one side, and Decrepit Up with the Paradise in Decomposition. Yeah, again, Decrepit Up is a great old school sounding death metal band. It's been quite a year, few years since their last release, so it will be cool to get some new stuff. Then we have Eternal Solstice and Pentacle. This is a double. Double 7 inch release. It's on colored vinyl. Kind of again, Blackpool orange, or maybe Dutch orange this time, since Pentacle and are from the Netherlands. Kind of natural to have that color then. And always when there is a tank on the inner, you know, that's kind of what kind of style of death metal you get as well. So yeah, pretty good release this one. I really like Pentacle. Then we have a Swedish called Egypt, Angelic Darkness. This is pretty good. Was recorded in 92. This is a reissue from 2014 by Dumantia Records. Really good Swedish death metal. I think they're from Sweden. Yeah. Kind of a used to be a hidden gem before the reissue, but I think more people are aware of it, but yeah, it's a good one. Then we have some Norwegian Viking black metal, Einherjar, Lev Vikingonden. Remember when this came out in 95? Maybe. Another cool death metal, Eminent Shadow with Perverted Liturgy. Another one of these holdouts. Yeah, this is great stuff. I really like this band. Again, the old school, a bit occult feeling to them, slow or mid-paced death metal. Then we have Ectovoid, Inner Death, out on Blood Harvest. Pretty a cool cover as well. Don't know if this is a fold out as well. Yeah, I like this when they do these fold outs. They are better than normal covers, I think, for singles, because it's easier to, yeah, it's less stuff to take care of. So pretty cool with and just have the single placed in there and close it. So I don't know about you, how you prefer your singles, but I think it's a good way to do it. And last we have Excruciation, Haunted, split with Heavy Death, Descending. Check it out. Again, it's a fold out, so the inner artwork as well, and yeah, that was what I had for this video, and it turned out to be even longer than the last one, so sorry about that. I tried to do it fast so it won't get too boring. Then we have 4 more episodes to shoot, and thanks for watching. Ich hoffe.